Have you ever wanted a small touch display that not just a screen but a full ESP32 based development board? Today we are checking out the 2.4 inch Crowpanel HMI ESP32 based display, a compact yet powerful display module designed for IoT dashboards, control panels and smart devices.
The Crow offers electronic kits for IoT displays and STEM and custom PCBA manufacturing for prototypes and production, and they have sent me one of their awesome touch displays. Inside this box, we get the Crowpanel 2.4 inch display itself, which comes with an ESP32 chip on board. This is a resistive touch screen, and here we also get some connectors with it. And there is also a Type-C USB port for programming and power, and depending on the kit, you may also get pin headers or accessories. Crowpanel ESP32 display is a 2.4 HMI screen of a 240 by 320 resolution LCD display, powered by the ESP32 Room 32. It has a dual core 32-bit Extensa LX6 MCU, integrated Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and up to 240 MHz frequency, great for IoT and more. It can be powered and programmed using the Type-C, and it can also be powered using a battery. Supports development environment like Arduino IDE, Asperif IDF, Dua RTOS, MicroPython. It is also compatible with open source graphics library like the LVGL. It has peripheral interfaces and expansion functions, enables it to meet the needs of different fields. Here are some of the features and specifications. Programming the Crowpanel is not that straightforward. You can use the Arduino IDE or Platform IO, but it has got some steps. It also supports the LVGL graphics library, which makes creating professional looking GUIs much easier. You can actually use the Squireline Studio for doing the same. I'll be sharing how to work with the Squireline Studio in the next few videos. For now, I won't be covering that, but I'll show you the demo of it. So this is the demo sketch that comes to your hand freshly. To work with our display, we have to do some steps. Before that, I'll show you some of the things that this thing is capable of doing. Let's get to the steps. First of all, you need to have the ESP32 boards installed in the Arduino IDE. Then you should go and download the library TFT ESPi by Boardmer. Next, you go to the GitHub repo and navigate to the user setup.h for 2.4, 2.8, 3.5 inch display and go for the 2.4 inch. You copy that and go to your file manager and find the Arduino, then libraries. Then search for TFT ESPi and find the user setup.h file and replace it with the code you just copied and then save the file. Next, go to the examples TFT ESPi 320 by 240. The board should be set to ESP32 Room DA module. After making sure everything is right, then you can upload the code. It's better if you choose the huge MP Spiffs app for better memory management or getting lots of memory. The code chip copy paste directly from the GitHub repo may not work properly. You need to add the pin mode 27 or also set it to high because it is actually the backlight of the display. Otherwise, it won't work properly. If you haven't done that, then you may not be able to see anything. Where can you actually use this thing? It can be used as a home automation dashboard to control smart devices, as an IoT display for sensors and data logging, for industrial control panels or prototyping HMI systems, or even as a standalone mini gadget like a moment or a timer or a media controller or as a calendar, whatever you can imagine. Crowpanel 2.4 inch HMI ESP32 display is a solid choice if you want a small but powerful touch display for your projects. It's affordable, versatile and beginner friendly. If you are interested, I'll leave a link in the description where you can check it out. This isn't the only size. They have got multiple different boards available in different sizes and different specifications. You can definitely go and check out the Electro website. I have listed the necessary links below. I really loved this board. It's really fantastic and you can expect more projects and tutorials based on this thing. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe for more IoT and embedded systems content. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one.